You've seen this image before, right? it's just Brewer being a scaremonger, quoting that other scaremonger, the Centers for Disease Control, CDC, talking about how we've got an epidemic of prediabetes. We've got a generation in jeopardy, 84.1 million, and 90% of those people don't know that they have it. You know, there are some people like Charles Pillar, who would say it's a good thing. Those 90% that don't know about it don't need to know about it. Where's the problem, he'd say? Where's the damage? There is no damage. He wrote an article, editorial in Science Magazine in March of 2019. The title was Dubious Diagnosis. He goes on to compare it to high blood pressure and says, you know, we don't call high blood pressure pre-stroke. And we don't really, therefore, need to focus on high blood pressure. It's exactly because we focused on high blood pressure as pre-stroke and we're treating people that we weren't treating 20 years ago. It's exactly for that reason that stroke has gone from number three cause of death down to number four and five, depending on how you want to count it. We're making slow progress, admittedly, but he got it all wrong. Now, let's talk. This video is a little bit more. I've done another video on Pillar and how he, what he covered and where he made mistakes. But let's focus a little bit more deeply on the fact that prediabetes does cause damage. According to his video, it doesn't cause any symptoms. I would agree. But he also said it has no complications. That's wrong. Let me go back and quote that scaremonger, CDC. Prediabetes is serious. It's a serious risk for heart attack and stroke. Prediabetes is a serious health condition where blood sugar levels are higher than normal, but not high enough yet to be diagnosed as type 2 diabetes. Approximately 84 million American adults, more than one out of three, have prediabetes. Of those with prediabetes, 90% don't know it. But prediabetes puts you at increased risk of developing type 2 diabetes, of course, but heart attack and stroke, and also eye disease, kidney disease, dementia. Really? Am I not stretching the point? No, I'm not stretching the point. Let's look at the American Association of Clinical Endocrinologists and retinopathy. By the time the diagnosis is made, let's go down to the bottom here, retinopathy. Diabetic retinopathy is the leading cause of blindness in adults in the United States. Leading cause of blindness. About 30% of patients with newly diagnosed type 2 diabetes already have evidence of diabetic retinopathy. In other words, the diabetic retinopathy occurred during prediabetes. Prevalence increases with duration and severity of disease. So, no, I would call retinopathy or eye damage, which leads to blindness, as a complication, Mr. Pillar. Neuropathy, what about that? Neuropathy is the most common side effect and complication of diabetes. But what about with prediabetes? Well, this is, again, the American Association of Clinical Endocrinologists. In addition to those with type 2 diabetes, patients with metabolic syndrome or prediabetes are at risk for various neuropathies, which develop as a result of, now guess what? Develop as a result of oxidative stress and inflammation. So it goes with every tissue in the body where we have arteries. Whether it's the heart, the brain, kidneys, eyes, you name it. And here's what happens with those arteries. On the left, we have an artery that's in basically normal condition. There's a little bit of LDL that has gone through the lining and lodged in between the intima and media. But this, as you go to the right, the prediabetes gets worse and worse. The atherosclerosis gets worse and worse. As you see, we start to get, as you start getting to this point, it's more than just LDL that has gone through the lining of the artery and into the space between the intima and media. Now there are other cells. There's inflammatory cells, monocytes, T cells, lymphocytes, neutrophils, and they're releasing enzymes. Those enzymes are doing what they're supposed to do. They're digesting the fat, the LDL. But unfortunately, when that happens, you get the next step, which again the immune system is targeting. You want to the immune system thinks that it wants to dissolve that fat and digest it. But here's the problem of that whole thing. Once you start getting that fat liquefied, if it breaks out and goes out and hits the artery wall, I mean the blood in the artery, you can get a clot. So just to go briefly through the scenario, these are three different views of an artery where you had a heart attack. This is the media, the muscular area, that red space. There is a thin one cell lining, the slick inner lining, and that is the intima. In between that intima and media, you have layer upon layer of plaque. That's basically LDL. In this case, you see that it's actually liquefied, that area between the intima and the media. That's where the immune system has attacked this plaque and actually begun to dissolve it. And what you see here is there's very little between that hot liquid plaque and the blood flow. And guess what? If that breaks through, it can cause a clot. And that's exactly what happened here. This was the media. This is the intima. There were cracks. This is not hot plaque here, this black stuff. This black stuff is a clot. As that hot plaque flowed through the crack in the intima layer, it touched the blood, it formed a clot, and that clot went on back into this area as well as breaking off here. The larger portion that broke off killed that patient. So as you see, insulin resistance or prediabetes is not, as Charles Piller said, without complication. It has a major complication. Cardiovascular inflammation and plaque. And what happens if you get cardiovascular inflammation and plaque? What does it cause? Heart attack and stroke and most dementia. So when you think about it, the complications are actually pretty serious, because the complications of insulin resistance or prediabetes actually lead to the number one killer, heart attack, and the number one disabler, stroke. So please don't let anyone tell you that the CDC or the ADA or I are scaremongers. If you tend to see it that way, then I'm very happy to be guilty as charged. Thank you for your interest. If you hit the like button, and for sure if you subscribe or share, the algorithm reads that as a strong message that humans think this is interesting and important information, and the algorithm can share it more than any of us humans. speaking of sharing, one of the best ways of sharing is on social media. We've got active Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn activities going on right now. We've recently started up things in Pinterest and Twitter, so we'd love to see you there. Check us out. Finally, with over 500 videos, a lot of people are saying, I can't find this video or that video. Our new social media manager, Kim Hermosa, is starting to work on ways to help with that. So join the community. You can click on the links below, and you can get a little bit better access. Thank you again for your interest.